Family and friends sharing the pain of a mother. Ayşe's 18-year-old son had gone across the border to Syria to join the Kurdish YPG militants and fight against the Islamic State. He was killed 2 weeks ago. Now, Ayşe says, Turkish authorities will not allow his body back into the country to be buried.
My son wasn't fighting the Turkish army. He was fighting the Islamic State. IS beheaded people. They killed the elderly. Why aren't they allowing my son back? This is an insult.
More than 4,000 people from Turkey, predominantly Kurds, have gone to fight against the IS. Up until recently, those killed were brought back into Turkey for their funeral. But now, the bodies of 23 fighters have been stopped at the border. This, families suspect, is part of a measure to keep the border town of Suruç calm. Here, an attack by the IS killed 32 people last month.
What happened here in Suruç has changed Turkey drastically. The government says it's now fighting both the IS and the Kurdish militant group PKK. There's an increased level of threat, and many fear peace is now something of the past and there's more trouble ahead.
Early this week, violence struck across Turkey in retaliation to the increasing operations against the PKK. The ceasefire that lasted for 3 years is in tatters. There are calls for de-escalation.
First of all, both sides should lay down arms and take the necessary steps to stop the clashes. They should agree on a ceasefire, return back to the negotiation table and start a dialogue.
Ayşe had 11 sons. One is now dead in Syria, another is a soldier in Turkish army, and another a policeman. She says she wants peace, so that mothers won't have to shed any more tears. Selin Girit, BBC News, Turkey-Syrian border.